Yo, what up, y'all? Intravenous here, back with another episode. Today, we're taking a look at the Q2 from WeLoHas. This is what appears to be Amazon's entry into this long-running Chinese handheld competition, where these new handhelds come up and get released every month or so. Happy hour start here, by the way. So if you're looking for happy hour, it's starting early with the WeLoHas Q2. Has an upgraded HD screen, 10,000 games, and support for 3D games. Interesting button layout. You can see the full specs here on the back. Feel free to pause it and check that out if you want. It says upgraded screen because there is an older version of this that's slightly cheaper that apparently has a lesser quality screen. This is the newer version. It sells for $32.99, free shipping out the door on Amazon.com. I got it next day delivery. We got a little analog stick sticking out here. This is actually a decent packaging for such an affordable handheld. USB-C charging cable. And here is our WeLoHas. The Q2, let's get it out of this padding, see if there's anything underneath. We got a little instruction manual and nothing else. So, let's get this out of the way. I'm surprised by how well that is. A little magnet on the flap there. Well packaged. So, here's the manual. It may have some information we could use, I'm not sure. Let's get this out of the plastic wrap. Our Q2. You might have seen on the back here, this comes in four colors. I picked the reddish one. They're all these like camo variants, and I'm not really big on camo colors, so I picked the red and black because it was like the least military style. I wanted to be more artistic looking, you know? So we got a volume wheel over here. I like that instead of buttons. Power switch, headphone jack. We got a micro SD card slot. And nothing else on the side here. The back, very simple. We got our Q2 model there, 1500 milliamperage hours. And yeah, you know, it feels kind of light in the hands, not too light. All right, here we are, flash forward to the future. I've actually been using this device for a few days, and there's a lot to be said about it. This thing is pretty impressive. It handles PS1 games really well. Unfortunately, it has L and R buttons on the front, just like a previous handheld that we've talked about on the channel, which was the Neocade GB Pocket. In fact, they're similar in size. You'll find that the Q2 is just slightly smaller with a 2.8-inch screen instead of a 3-inch screen, but the screen itself is a much better resolution than the GB Pocket, which begs the question, why did they put such a terrible screen on this? I don't know. For $32.99, we got an excellent screen on here with 10,000 games. Everything from the Atari loaded all the way up through the PS1. It plays it all excellent and handles PS1 very well. It's unfortunate that it doesn't have L2 or R2 buttons, and the L1 and R1 buttons are located on the front and the middle, precariously placed. But there are many games on PS1 that you can actually play without using the L2 and R2 buttons. And actually, even many games that don't even use the L and R buttons for the most part. So, those games you can really enjoy on here, and they look great. We've got PS1, MAME, Famicom, Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Color, Mega Drive, Super Famicom, Atari, Neo Geo, and back to the PlayStation 1. We've got favorites, history, settings, search, and download. The search is handy, but unfortunately, it only finds games that start with the word that you're searching. So if I type in Mario here, it's only going to show the games that have Mario as the first word, leaving out Super Mario. And so you might think over here, you press left and select these, you might think over here, oh man, this has only like the old weird Mario games. Like, what, we got Mario Golf and Mario's Time Machine. We got Mario Kart. Okay. A lot of Mario missing. And that's because you want to look for Super Mario to get all the other ones. This has all the Marios. It has pretty much every game that you could want on it. Though some of them are labeled as different names. So you might think that you don't have a game on here like Zelda. But then you find The Legend of Salda, S-A-L-D-A. And you find that it's actually the full game. And you might have it in English, in Japanese, in German, multiple versions on here. So there are repeats. depending on the language that you're using, you'll pick the ones you want to play. And that can be a little annoying when cycling through games because you'll find multiples of games. You'll see here in Game Boy Advance, it has 1,088 games. It has pretty much every Game Boy Advance game you could think of, but not all of them. It has a lot of Pokemon games included, but they're all ROM hacks and not the best. And some of them would be like Leaf Green in Chinese or Japanese. So you could see this just goes forever. You can also go to the right and scroll through these quicker. And for the most part, these all play well. But you'll find here, like, see Golden Sun, we have it in Dutch, English, Spanish, French, Italian. And they don't have Golden Sun, too. So you don't have all the games. But there sure is a lot. Let's just take a look at a game here. So this is Super Mario Advance or Super Mario 2, you know. It looks really good. Look at the viewing angles on this screen. You can see it from any angle. The audio's pretty good. You have a lot of room here. It can go too loud. And then, yeah, it gets a little crunchy. But I mean, you really got options here. You can go with just a little bit of volume, which I like having the option to do just a little bit of volume with this wheel. One odd thing is when it's turned all the way down, it still has just the faintest audio coming out of it. You can only really tell if you put your ear up to it. But this thing is pretty freaking sweet. When you hit the home button, you have the option to save states, and each game has six save state slots, which are very handy, and you can load as well. Now, like I said, PlayStation works really well on here, and though you get a lot of games that might be in Chinese or Japanese, which is unfortunate if you read in English, you have this download option. And with the download spot, you can add your own games. And the strange thing about this is you have to add them to the download folder and go through your games in there, the added games. For some reason, even though you can see all of the ROMs in the folder when browsing this in the file system on your computer, you can delete ROMs from those folders, you can change the names, and when you put the card back in here, those ROMs will still be listed, the same name as before and everything. They just won't load anymore. So the same goes for if you try to add your own ROMs into those files. There's nothing that shows up in the folder when you turn it on. They only show up if you put them in the download folder. And I think that has something to do with the strange way they built this UI. They have it like coded in the actual list. All these numbers are not built into the name of the game either. So you'll find in here, like go to Game Boy, we got 6411 is the first game. Now, when you go in the ROMs, it doesn't say 6411, it just says Add a Family Tree, which is actually the Addams Family, which is another mistake. So you'll find that it plays all the games on here really well, and it has almost every game you could want, at least from Nintendo to the Game Boy Advance. The Atari actually has some really fun games, and it seems to play multiple different Atari consoles because we have some of the older Atari, and then we have like some newer ones. Like, for example, an older Atari would be Frankenstein's Monster, which is actually really fun. I was surprised how fun this is. But then you can go ahead and scroll further down, and we have Jinx. Jinx has voices. And it's more like an NES style game. It came out 1989, 1987 copyrights there. So, you know, this must be, I'm not too privy on information for the Atari, but I believe this is more like an Atari 5200 game or 7800 or something like that. So that's pretty cool. I think I've said it before, but Atari is a welcome console on these handhelds. They should put it on there more often because they're fun games and they're good for quick plays. So I think the sweet spot for this handheld really is the Game Boy consoles just because of the form factor, but it really plays all of these quite well. So let's go ahead and take a look at some gameplay. Alright y'all, so there it is. What do you think about the Q2 from Wilohas? I think, as far as budget handhelds that are available on Amazon.com, this is definitely a good deal because everything's more expensive on Amazon and you can't even find this on AliExpress. It's only on Amazon for $32.99 free shipping. I mean, they sell the Pow Kitty V90 for like $60 on Amazon still, and this thing runs better than that. There were some audio stutters, and you do have the problem with some of the missing buttons and the layout. It's kind of like a depends on what you're into type of thing. I will say that I kind of think this analog stick is welcome because as I'm getting older, I'm starting to get carpal tunnel, and I find sometimes I get like fatigue in my thumb, especially right here from doing the D-pad too much, and this feels so much better on it. I don't get that fatigue in my thumb, so this is something that I'll use when I feel like playing games on a handheld, but my hands are uncomfortable, sort of. So, like, I can play this easier. And the screen looks great. Also, I like that I can add my own games and that it handles PS1 so well, even though it's not really made for that. I think what it's best for is, like, the Game Boy games. But I don't know. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. I appreciate y'all sticking around. I'll leave a link in the description for this if you want to buy your own. And please hit the like and subscribe buttons if you like this. If you're not subscribed, helps me out and encourages me to make more videos. And I will catch you on the next episode. Peace out. Childhood, we were all there together. And in denial would play like it was forever. And in the tall woods, we'd stay out of the weather. Like it was all good. Every day we made it for pleasure. We were saying whatever came to our minds, plain and simple like a tetherball reaching the sky. We were taking new heights on the swing while it was making us fly. Beat the king of the hill and everything will be fine. The thrill of everything we would find, the innocence of a child.